हेलो स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 10, आई एम इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू विद वन मोर टॉपिक ऑफ द चैप्टर पावर शेयरिंग, राइट? डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट वीडियो आई जस्ट एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द गवर्नमेंट स्टेप्स, राइट? गवर्नमेंट स्टेप्स फॉर गिविंग द प्रायोरिटी ऑफ the language sinlas and the working for or making them happy, the different strategy and programs made for sinlas communities and how such policies of the government creates problem resulted to civil war in Sri Lanka, means only formation of the government on the basis of majority is not sufficient condition for ideal democratic ruling system, right? Only the method of election, electoral politics is not sufficient conditions for successing the democracy, right? It was just seen. It is necessary for making the government or democracy successful, there is need of power sharing and having equal role or participation of every community of the society. Then it is possible that the form of the government be successful, right? And democracy be also fruitful, right? Now, as you will see the situation of Sri Lanka, that there were two major community speaking different languages. Now at the same situation in Belgium also. In Belgium, there were French speaking, Dutch speaking and German speaking peoples residing in whole nation. As I told you in second last previous video, that in Belgium, in whole country, much more population was just speaking Dutch, and after that second language spoken maximally there was French, and only 1% of people were just speaking, only 1% of the people were just speaking German. Means there was the situation of whole country. In whole country there were 59% people speaking Dutch, right? But in Wallonia regions, southern or northern regions, in southern and northern region, the just Belgium was divided. In whole France, 59% people were Dutch speaking, 40% in Wallonia region just speaks French, and 1% people just speak German. But this was the situation of whole country. But whenever you will see the situation of the Brussels, the capital city of Belgium, in capital city the maximum 80% people just speaking French, and only 20% people just speaking Dutch. Means what was the situation? In whole country there was majority of the Dutch, and in capital city there was majority of French. So there was the situation of the conflict between both the community. If we will see the country election, obviously what was just happening there, it happens there that there was the majority of the Dutch, so the government will form in parliament. There was the majority of the Dutch people, But whenever you will see the capital city, there were maximum people's friends. So what happened in capital, from where the whole ruling of the nation was just controlled, having majority of the French. So this creates struggle between both the community. Now it was the challenge for the government, if power was not accommodated properly, if power is not subdivided properly in different community, it may be possible there is condition of the hard violence in Belgium. So when the constitution was just made, and it is written here, between 1970 to 1993, there were four times there were amendment in Belgian constitution, means to sort out or solve the problem of the distrust between the French and German peoples. It was done by the Belgian parliament, the reformation or amendment of constitution four times, as there was not any type of dispute, as there was participation of every community in the government, because they recognized the diversity, right? They just gave the importance of every community equally. If any country of the world having democratical ruling or any type of ruling will just understanding and giving importance of every peoples or every community equal, then that government be ideal and successful. So what happened in Belgium? When it was seen there is language diversity in the whole country, so government understand the importance of diversity, and they just try to maintain the diversity. And for maintaining diversity, there were so many steps will be taken by the government, as there is not any type of dispute be created between the different language speaking peoples. In this context, what happened? There were four times there was amendment in the constitution, as there should be equal participation of every community. Such situation and such steps was not taken in Sri Lanka, and that causes distrust and civil war. So it is the responsibility of the government. The power must be shared in different organs on different community. Then they will feel real nationalism. Then they will feel love and affection towards their nation. Then they will work for development of their native land or nation. Right? So it is the summary of the accommodation in Belgium, that government will not give importance of any special community, either on the basis of the majority or the minority. Government will give equal importance of every community. And they will after the election, whatever the peoples will give the vote or do not give the vote, it was not matter. And such policy was, or such program or such strategy was made, as every people just got benefited. Right? So now we will see few models, right, few steps what was just taken for making diversity beautiful, giving equality and liberty to every community, not only giving but feeling the feelings in the heart of every community about the equality, right? So dear students, what happened? Actually, in very short, just remind, Belgium, an ideal model of democracy. Whole world just follow. whole world just pressed about the model of democracy of Belgium. Right? Actually, what happened? Leaders in Belgium took different paths when the government was formed. Right? The different governments just recognized, understand the importance of diversities. And for maintaining diversity, what happened? There were four times constitution amendment. Right? What happened for the improvement or for the giving importance of diversity? Four amendment was done between 1793. Now some important elements of the Belgian model to accommodations are: what are the different steps which was taken by the leaders or the government? Right? Actually, the government was three layers of the government was made, right? For making more participation of people and for welfareness at every level of the nation, at every level of the community, there were formation of the government. So there were three tier of government. The model of three tier government was taken by Belgium, right? Constitution prescribes that number of French and Dutch speaking ministers should be equal in central government. Thus, no single community can make decisions unilaterally from any community, either from Dutch or French. It doesn't matter. The Dutch ministers just come in more number, or French just come in less number, it doesn't matter. But in central government, from every community, equal numbers of ministers will be in the government, and equal numbers of ministers will give equal importance, right, and make ideal policy for all. राइट मतलब यहाँ पर समझने की जरूरत है कि ये मतलब वहाँ के गवर्नमेंट ने किया, इलेक्शन में जिसकी भी मेजोरिटी आए या माइनोरिटी कम आए मैटर नहीं करता है, बल्कि सरकार में जीती हुई पार्टी का भी और हारी हुई पार्टी का भी, मतलब गवर्नमेंट जिसको मेजोरिटी मिला हो उसका भी और जो पार्टी हारी है उसके भी, सभी के उस सभी कम्युनिटी से बराबर बराबर मिनिस्टर्स को लिया गया। ठीक है, सभी कम्युनिटी के बराबर बराबर मिनिस्टर होंगे, और जब बराबर बराबर मिनिस्टर होंगे तो निश्चित रूप से क्या होगा, सभी कम्युनिटी के लिए काम होगा। किसी एक कम्युनिटी का तो उसमें मेजोरिटी नहीं रह गया, भले ही एक मेजोरिटी के लोग ज्यादा होने के बाद जिसको भी चुना हो वो मैटर नहीं करता है, लेकिन सरकार बनने में, मिनिस्टर के फॉर्मेशन में सभी कम्युनिटी से बराबर मिनिस्टर्स को लिया जाएगा, जो कि मिलकर के समान पॉलिसी बना सके और एक दूसरे कोई एक दूसरे से एलिनेटेड और सुप्रीमेसी और इंफीरियरिटी फील ना करें। राइट, इसलिए सभी कम्युनिटी को इक्वल जस्टिस देने के लिए, डच स्पीकिंग हो या फ्रेंच स्पीकिंग हो, दोनों से इक्वल मिनिस्टर्स को चुना गया। किस चीज में? सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट के फॉर्मेशन में। दस नो सिंगल कम्युनिटी कैन मेक डिसीजन यूनिलिटरली, मतलब कोई एक कम्युनिटी अकेले रूप से पूरे कंट्री के लिए डिसीजन नहीं बना सकता था, ऐसा पहला पॉलिसी बनाया गया। ठीक है, सेकंड, पावर्स वेयर गिवन टू द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, दे वेयर नॉट सबॉर्डिनेट टू सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट। पहले बताया कि गवर्नमेंट को तीन लेवल में बांटा गया, थ्री टायर में। पहला टायर सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट में सारे कम्युनिटी से इक्वल मिनिस्टर्स को लिया गया। दूसरे लेवल पे स्टेट गवर्नमेंट को लिया गया, और एक बात समझने की है कि स्टेट गवर्नमेंट को सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट का सबॉर्डिनेट या उसके असिस्ट के रूप में नहीं या उसके नीचे में नहीं, पैरेलल के रूप में ले सकते हैं। मतलब स्टेट गवर्नमेंट जो बनाया गया, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट को इंडिपेंडेंट पावर दिया गया, और वो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट के अंदर में काम नहीं करता था। उनकी वर्क्स एंड रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी क्या था? डिफाइन था, जैसे कि इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में भी है, यूनियन गवर्नमेंट स्टेट गवर्नमेंट है ना, तो यूनियन स्टेट गवर्नमेंट यूनियन गवर्नमेंट के अंदर में नहीं आती है। यूनियन गवर्नमेंट का कानून बनाने के, रूल्स बनाने के अलग दायरे हैं, उनके अलग लिस्ट हैं, यूनियन लिस्ट, स्टेट लिस्ट, कंकरेंट लिस्ट पढ़े हो आपने इंडिया में। तो उसी तरह से बेल्जियम में जो है ये क्या किया गया, यूनियन गवर्नमेंट सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट के बाद स्टेट गवर्नमेंट अलग बनाया गया, और स्टेट गवर्नमेंट के पावर्स को सेपरेट किया गया, और स्टेट गवर्नमेंट को यूनियन गवर्नमेंट के नीचे नहीं माना गया। ठीक है, वो उनका वर्किंग एरिया, उनके नियम, उनको लॉ पॉलिसी स्ट्रेटजी बनाने का इंडिपेंडेंसी था और उसमें सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट का कोई इंटरफेयर नहीं हो सकता था। ठीक है, तो पावर्स वेयर गिवेन टू द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, दे वेयर नॉट सबॉर्डिनेट टू सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, मतलब स्टेट गवर्नमेंट विल नॉट जस्ट वर्क अंडर द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, दे जस्ट टेक डिसीजंस इंडिपेंडेंटली फ्रॉम द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट। लेट अस कंटिन्यू द थर्ड पॉइंट, व्हाट हैपेंड मींस वन गवर्नमेंट एट द यूनियन लेवल, अनदर गवर्नमेंट एट द स्टेट लेवल एंड सेपरेट गवर्नमेंट फॉर द ब्रुसेल कैपिटल सिटी, right? Separate governments because the situation and condition of the Brussels was totally different in Belgium. Because in whole Belgium there was majority of Dutch and French just come in second position. But what was the situation of the Brussels? In Brussels 80% only French and 20% 20% Dutch. So the separate government for the capital is just taken as there was certain separate situation of there, right? Since the government is the whole country's development, all policies are just dependent on capital city. So separate government, the provisions of separate government was taken at capital city in the Brussels. Brussels has a separate government in which both the community has equal representation. Pure countries mein jab barabar union government barabar participation diya gaya majority ko side karke, to phir kya hua, Brussels mein bhi jo government bani to bhale hi Dutch wahan pe kitne the 20% the, lekin wahan par bhi French aur Dutch ko dono ko equal participation diya gaya government banane mein, koi bhi jeete कोई भी हारे मैटर नहीं करता है, लेकिन मेंबर्स दोनों के क्या होंगे, हैविंग इक्वल मेंबर्स इन बोथ द कम्युनिटीज, राइट? सो व्हाट हैपेंड, ब्रुसेल्स हैज अ सेपरेट गवर्नमेंट इन विच बोथ द कम्युनिटीज हैज इक्वल रिप्रेजेंटेशन एंड थर्ड टाइप ऑफ गवर्नमेंट इज कम्युनिटी गवर्नमेंट। और गवर्नमेंट का एक और लेयर का एस्टेब्लिशमेंट किया गया कम्युनिटी लेवल में, मीन मतलब प्रत्येक यूनिट लेवल पे, विलेज लेवल पे, रीजन लेवल पे, लैंग्वेज लेवल पर, प्रत्येक लेवल पर लोगों का डेवलपमेंट हो, लोगों की डिजायर फुलफिल हो, इसलिए थर्ड लेवल पे एक जो है कम्युनिटी गवर्नमेंट के मॉडल्स को एक्सेप्ट किया गया और वो कम्युनिटी गवर्नमेंट को स्टेट गवर्नमेंट और यूनियन गवर्नमेंट से बिल्कुल इंडिपेंडेंट रखा गया और उनके लॉ बनाने के एरियाज को क्या कर दिया गया, उनके लॉ बनाने के एरियाज को डिफाइन कर दिया गया, जैसे कि दिस गवर्नमेंट हैड पावर रिगार्डिंग कल्चरल, ठीक है, एजुकेशनल एंड लैंग्वेज रिलेटेड इशूज, राइट? तो मतलब जो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, जो थर्ड लेवल का कम्युनिटी गवर्नमेंट था, इसको जो था लॉ बनाने के एरियाज को स्पेसिफाइड कर दिया, कल्चर से रिलेटेड, अपने लोकल एरियाज के एजुकेशन से रिलेटेड, लैंग्वेज से रिलेटेड, ठीक है, इन सारे इशूज पर जो है वो सेपरेट लॉ बना सकता था और उसमें देर वॉज नॉट इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट और द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ऑफ द ब्रुसेल्स, सॉरी सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ऑफ बेल्जियम। मीन्स By this model, it was taking care of every communities of peoples, as every community of peoples will feel the government is just working for them and they are just part of the government. Whenever so big model of the ruling, obviously there were the more and more participations of the people. Right? And whenever there was more and more peoples of the participation in the government, it was the feeling that the peoples are just participant of the government. It is the objective of democracy. Right? So, due to taking such models, there was not feeling when everyone was given equal rights, then there is not space for creating the ideas or sentiments of alienations among the people. So you will see here in Belgium or Sri Lanka, since government will give the importance of the every community in Belgium. Power will be subdivided among different community, so the government of Belgium be successful, the model of democracy of Belgium successful. But what happened in Sri Lanka? The only majority peoples just giving the importance of only one majority, that causes the civil war. So you will now, I think you will just understand two situation, and I think now you have an image just created in your mind about power sharing. What is meaning of power sharing and what is benefits of power sharing? So dear students, with furtherly, with comparative study, right, we will come again in next video. Thank you. Have a nice day.